Y'all pee. Day ready. It's the new swag, baby. Woke up this morning and I told myself, not gonna worry about what I cannot help.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to morning.
Whoa. He's got a, yeah. He's got a, whoa. He's got a, yeah. Check it out.
I ain't worried about the money in the bank.
Come on.
I ain't gonna worry about the gas in the tank.
Fill me up. I ain't worried about it.
I ain't gonna worry about the things I can't control.
It is what it is.
I ain't gonna worry about it. All I do is pray about it.
Hold up. Why?
God's got it.
Yes, he does.
God's got it.
I look around and my heart is a little heavy. The money's fading fast and I'm looking for a blessing. People looking for jobs, no one looking for God. I know that you heard, but in time God is really gonna work. Whoa, he's got a, yeah. He's got a, whoa. Why?
The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Hear us, O Lord, for your mercy is great. We will exalt you, O God, our Savior, and praise your name forever and ever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. O come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his face with thanksgiving and cry out to him joyfully in psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he himself is our God. We are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. If only you would hear his voice today, for he comes. He comes to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with righteousness and the people with his truth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our psalm appointed for today is Psalm 89, verses 1 to 18. Psalm 89, part 1.
Psalm 89. Your love, O Lord, forever will I sing. From age to age my mouth will proclaim your faithfulness.
For I am persuaded that your love is established forever. You have set your faithfulness firmly in the heavens.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn an oath to David, my servant.
I will establish your line forever and preserve your throne for all generations.
The heavens bear witness to your wonders, O Lord, and to your faithfulness in the assembly of the holy ones.
For who in the skies can be compared to the Lord? Who is like the Lord among the gods?
God is much to be feared in the council of the holy ones, great and terrible to all those round about him.
Who is like you, Lord God of hosts? O mighty Lord, your faithfulness is all round you.
You rule the raging of the sea and still the surging of its waves.
You have crushed Rahab of the deep with a deadly wound. You have scattered your enemies with your mighty arm.
Yours are the heavens, the earth also is yours. You laid the foundations of the world and all that is in it.
You have made the north and the south. Tabor and Hermon rejoice in your name.
You have a mighty arm. Strong is your hand and high is your right hand.
Righteousness and justice are the foundations of your throne. Love and truth go before your face.
Happy are the people who know the festal shout. They walk, O Lord, in the light of your presence.
They rejoice daily in your name. They are jubilant in your righteousness.
For you are the glory of their strength, and by your favor all might is exalted.
Truly, the Lord is our ruler.
The Holy One of Israel is our King.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, taken from the Apostle Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, beginning at chapter 10, verse 14, concluding at chapter 11. Verse 1. Therefore, my dear friends, Flee from the worship of idols. I speak as to sensible people. Judge for yourselves what I say. The cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a sharing in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a sharing in the body of Christ? Because there is one bread, we who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread. Consider the people of Israel. Are not those who eat the sacrifices partners in the altar? What do I imply then? That food sacrificed to idols is anything, or that an idol is anything? No, I imply that what pagans sacrifice, they sacrifice to demons and not to God. I do not want you to be partners with demons. You cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of demons. You cannot partake of the table of the Lord and the table of demons. Or are we provoking the Lord to jealousy? Are we stronger than He? All things are lawful, but not all things are beneficial. All things are lawful, but not all things build up. Do not seek your own advantage, but that of the other. Eat whatever is sold in the meat market without raising any question on the ground of conscience, for the earth and its fullness are the Lord's. If an unbeliever invites you to a meal, and you are disposed to go, eat whatever is set before you without raising any question on the grounds of conscience. But if someone says to you, "This has been offered in sacrifice," then do not eat it, out of consideration for the one who informed you and for the sake of conscience. I mean the other's conscience, not your own. For why should my liberty be subject to the judgment of someone else's conscience? If I partake with thankfulness, why should I be denounced because of that for which I give thanks? So whatever you eat or drink, or whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God. Give no offense to Jews or to Greeks or to the Church of God. Just as I try to please everyone in everything I do, not seeking my own advantage, but that of many, so that they may be saved. Be imitators of me, as I am of Christ. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, taken from the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 7, verses 24 to 37. From there, he set out and went away to the region of Tyre. He entered a house and did not want anyone to know he was there.
yet he could not escape notice. But a woman whose little daughter had an unclean spirit immediately heard about him, and she came down and bowed down at his feet. Now the woman was a Gentile, of Syrophoenician origin. She begged him to cast the demon out of her daughter. He said to her, "Let the children be fed first, for it is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." But she answered him, "Sir, even the dogs under the table eat the children's crumbs." Then he said to her, "For saying that, you may go. The demon has left your daughter." So she went home, found the child lying on the bed, and the demon gone. Then he returned from the region of Tyre and went by way of Sidon towards the Sea of Galilee in the region of the Decapolis. They brought to him a deaf man who had an impediment in his speech, and they begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him aside in private, away from the crowd, and put his fingers into his ears, and he spat and touched his tongue. Then looking up to heaven, he sighed and said to him, "Ephphatha," that is, "be opened." And immediately his ears were opened, his tongue was released, and he spoke plainly. Then Jesus ordered them to tell no one. But the more he ordered them, the more zealously they proclaimed it. They were astounded beyond measure, saying, "He has done everything well. He even makes the deaf to hear and the mute to speak." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Be not dismayed, whatever betide, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide, God will take care of you. Through every day.
Hi, everyone. I want us to think about two memory verses this week. Or we can do one, whichever one gives you that boost, that strength that you need to get through this week. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. This is from John chapter 14, verse 6. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And also consider, you, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Philippians chapter 4, verses 11 to 13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I want us to take one or two and just recite it. Take it through a week. Take it through the day, take it through the week. Write it on the walls. Put a reminder on your phone, because it is important to help us to understand that with God, anything is possible. With God, anything is possible. Because He is the way. He's the way through whatever we might be going through. He is the life that we need. Sometimes we're just walking around there, dead, dragging, whatever might be bugging us down, but He is the way. And sometimes this world pumps so many lies into our head, so many things that keep us distracted, keep us depressed, keep us sad, keep us away from living this victorious life. He is the truth. He's the truth. And this comes out with His encounter, both encounters in our readings, but His specific encounter with the Syrophoenician woman. And many people have said, oh, He's calling the woman a dog. No, but He's not. You see, society has placed this stigma upon her because of where she was from. And so with this stigma, this, their own judgment of who she might be, they've said a lot. They've called them or referred to people from that clan as dogs. They're not worthy. They're worthless. They have nothing of value from them. They've wasted their time here on earth. And I'm saying it because these are the times that we live in as well. We put so much pressure on each other. We make people feel bad about themselves. We label them. We push them off on the side, and there's exclusion happening rather than inclusion. And Jesus is pointing out her, you know, just throw it at her. This is what the world says. Do you believe what the world says, or do you believe what I say? And she responds in humility. She responds, she goes to Him in humility, and she responds in humility and persistence. And I want us to just take that. Go to God humbly. Bow before Him. Bring all of your concerns, your struggles, whatever it might be, just pour it out before Him. And be persistent. Just wait for Him to respond. Wait for Him to respond. And His response was clear to her. You're still here? Oh, good. That means you are not concerned about the world, but you understand that I have it. I have the power. I'm here with you. I will take you through. And He says, he doesn't say this, but you know, it reminds me of another story where He says that your faith has made you well. Your faith. And so in that moment, we say, your daughter has been healed. And she goes home and meets that her daughter is well. And of course, He says, don't tell anybody yet, because His time had not come. But she could hold it in. She could not hold it in. She had to tell everybody what God had done for her, because He is powerful, mighty, strong. Abel did not even come to touch, but stayed from where he was and healed her daughter. And she couldn't hold it in. She couldn't hold it in. We don't have to hold it in now, because that time has already passed. As a matter of fact, now we must shout it from the ends of the earth. We must shout it and tell it to everyone how good this God is, how great He is. His love so freely poured out upon us. We must see it and believe it and share it. And then, of course, we have the other healing story where he doesn't come on his own. His friends bring him. His friends bring him along. That is so profound. That is so dynamic. That's something that we ought to consider. His friends brought him to Jesus. And he was healed. Jesus took him in a back room. Jesus had that quiet moment. Jesus turned his life around. Opened his ears so that he could hear. And then he tells him, don't say anything. But again, that encounter was so profound, so magnificent, so amazing, so wonderful, he wanted to share it with others. My brothers and sisters in Christ, I want us to consider, God is able to do measurably more than we can imagine, in more than we can conceive, more than we can consider. He is able to turn things around. He is able to make things happen. He is able to set our life in order. If we would bow down, if we would come humbly, if we would accept him. Because he can do all things. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is God. Give him a chance. Remember this, regardless of what the world says about you, regardless of how you might be feeling in the now, God can help you through that. God can take you through that. God can build you up, boost you up, and make your life possible. Because sometimes it feels impossible. So consider God and forget the world, because God will provide all that you need. Amen. So our memory verses: I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, and Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. I can do all things. Say it. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Christ is my strength, my rock, my healer, my guide. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus is the way I should go. He is the way to where I need to be. He is the way in the way I should live my life. The truth. He is the truth. He will never lie. The truth. And he is life. Life. Have a wonderful week, everyone. And so I invite us to confess boldly our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and your servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. Gracious Father, whose blessed Son Jesus Christ came down from heaven to be the true bread which gives life to the world, evermore give us this bread, that he may live in us and we in him, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I invite us to offer our own petitions at this time. Let us pray for a productive week. Loving and Heavenly Father, you are the source of all our strength and motivation. Inspire us today with your divine inspiration. Encourage us today. Support us in all our doings. Give us strength and courage. Give us your helping and healing hand. That today and all of this week will be productive, that it will bring you honor and glory. Help us in planning out our day. Help us in paying attention to what is required of us. Help us to stay focused. Help us to prioritize. Help us to celebrate steady progress and achievements. Help us to have goals and objectives. Give us insight, dear Father. And remove from us or give us strength to remove any habits that may keep us from achieving what you require of us today and this week. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. A prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your Holy Word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons, in the power of the Holy Spirit, and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or conceive, by the power which is at work among us, to him be the glory in the Church and in Christ Jesus, throughout all ages. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a wonderful week, everyone. God bless you.
He's got a yeah. Check it out. I ain't going.